bus captain for this weekend. This is the yellow bus. We get back on a bus. What color is this bus?
Yellow!
Will we change buses?
No!
This is our bus.
But David Goodman is the brother of Andrew Goodman. Some of you may know that Andrew Goodman was one of the three young men that came to Mississippi during the summer of 1964, 50 years ago. They were stopped by the sheriff after leaving Ohio, where they had gone through training. Detained by the sheriff, arrested, taken to jail, and later the evening, they were taken from the jail, turned over to the Klan, where they were beaten, shot, and killed.
This is a wonderful opportunity. You'll learn so much about the history of our state. Even the bad parts needs talking about so that we can build on what used to be and say we won't ever let it happen again.
In 2001, Morgan Freeman and I renovated this turn of the century building. It's a renovation. Look around.
I got a call one morning from the COFO office in Jackson, and the voice on the phone said, go and get Fannie Lou Hamer and take her to get her qualified to be congressman, to run as a congressperson from the 2nd Congressional District. I said, how do you do that? He said, the person in the office said, I don't know. You find out.
This church here, it got a lot of history in it. This church was built in 1871, and it was built by field hands, and it's still standing. And it's been a big part of our community ever since I've been living, and that's a long time.
Yeah. 3 days later, they found Emmett's body. First place they looked for the rivers. Emmett should not have ever been found. Had it weighed down, but his body snagged, and his foot was bobbing up in the water. They pulled him out, and of course they said, this is not Emmett. This is an old white man that you guys have dug up out of the grave. And you came down here to embarrass Mississippi with this case. Emmett is in Detroit with his grandfather.
But to come here to Mississippi to see the sights, to understand some of the physical feeling of fear and a locale, it's really a revelation, as I say. I think it really opens your eyes and your heart.
All of a sudden, there was this huge explosion. The children fell to the floor. They were sitting on the floor, but they fell to the floor and began to crawl to the bathroom. And you could tell, those of you who have been in, how small that was, how it is. To be sure that they got in the tub with their little baby brother, because Medgar had trained them what to do in case something like this would happen. I made a dash for the door, turned on the porch light. The force of that bullet from the rifle had forced Medgar past his car, past my car, and he had fallen just about where you are, dear, with the keys in his hand, trying desperately to get into the house.
While I was sitting in that tub at around 7:30 in the morning, one of these children, that's all they were, came and said, they need you up the street at the office. Mega Evers has been shot and is dead. That means after putting me on the bus to go to the Delta around midnight, he went home. And that is when he was shot.
Assalamu alaikum, greetings of peace. The impact of the sacrifices that our activists here gave has not only had an impact on the Mississippi Delta, it broke the chains around the world.
That the death of Emmett Till was not in vain, since an invisible threat connects your civil rights struggle with our struggle against a brutal apartheid regime.
You need to be working together for the sake of your constituents and for the sake of your souls. And more than any of us could possibly have done with that South African credential, Ross was able to do it.
Let us not ever forget those who have sacrificed so much of themselves for what they believed in. This is my prayer. This is my plea. And this is my petition, O Lord.
It was last year when we were in Montgomery. There was a law enforcement there that played a big role in at least my memory of that trip. And it was there that the Montgomery Police Department officially apologized to John Lewis for not being there as they should have been, but they are there now. So, again.
So one thing about Mississippi is I hope you'll experience as you take back to Washington, D.C. and other places is the warmth that I hope you felt here and the love that you see among our people. And it's a great honor for me to be able to co-host this event with Congressman Thompson. And I thank him for all of his work.
Rosa Parks moved to Detroit, and I said, when I get elected, I'm going to hire her, make my first hire with her.
Wow.
And she accepted.
Nice.
For over a dozen years.
It's been a great, hey, look, the whole weekend has been magnificent. It really has. And this is a real pinnacle. And I love Faith in Politics. I go to the Wednesday morning prayer group that Faith in Politics has in the Senate, and it's a good group. Keeps us grounded.
There isn't any other organization that combines the consciousness of spirituality with the political process, and it really, and they do it well.
We're done.